Okay, so we continue our discussion of partial differential equations. We have been looking at so this classification of second order PDEs and how it's possible to make a suitable transformation to put the PDE into a canonical form. So in this lecture, we will concentrate on parabolic PDEs and work out the method by which we can write it in the canonical form. Okay, so the you know, the main method is to come up with a suitable transformation zeta of x comma y and eta of x comma y, and in terms of these new coordinates we will be able to rewrite this general second order PDE in terms of another second order PDE, which basically looks, you know, in form almost like the starting point, except that we have the power to choose these coefficients in a manner which is most convenient for the type of differential equation that we are studying. Right, so, and then we have worked out this general prescription by which capital A is related to all these small a, b, c, d, e, f, g, and these partial, in terms of these partial derivatives, like here b is given in terms of this relation, C is given in terms of this relation, D is given in terms of this relation, E, F and G are all written down, right? So which is something which we saw a couple of lectures ago. Once again, if you have not convinced yourself of this, now is a good opportunity to go back and check this and see for yourself that indeed this is the correct way to go from one basis to another basis, right? So it's like one set of coordinates to another set of coordinates. So in this lecture we are looking at parabolic PDEs, right? Our attention is focused on parabolic PDEs for which the discriminant is zero. Doesn't matter which, whether you are looking at the discriminant in terms of these small b, a and c, or in terms of this capital A, b and c. The discriminant is simply given by capital B squared minus 4ac or small b squared minus 4 small ac, both of which are going to be zero. Now, so like we said earlier, the type of the differential equation is just decided by A, B and C. So the other coefficients don't really matter as far as the type of the differential equation is concerned. And so in this case, it's convenient to actually to set B equal to zero and one of these two, either A or C, to be zero. Right, so if we do this, then automatically it means that the discriminant is zero. I mean when we start with a PDE of the parabolic type, of course we may not have this form where either A or C is zero. In fact, all three may be present, small a, small b and small c, right? In general it is true that all three are present. So the idea is that if you can take it to a new PDE in which small b, capital B is zero, and either A or C, or zero, then you're going to get a PDE which has a much simpler form, which will be in the canonical form, as we will see. Now, suppose we set capital A equal to zero. So what it means is we set this quantity, you know, according to this transformation, we will set this to be equal to zero. A times dou zeta by dou x the whole squared plus B times dou zeta by dou x times dou zeta by dou y plus C times dou zeta by dou y the whole squared equal to 0, right? So this corresponds to this quadratic equation in this ratio. So I can divide throughout by dou zeta by dou y the whole squared. So I get this quadratic equation in this ratio, dou zeta by dou x the whole thing divided by dou zeta by dou y, and which can be solved, right? So we know how to solve a quadratic equation. So if we solve this quadratic equation, we are going to get only one root, right? Because this is of parabolic type, right? So we have this, we know that the discriminant is zero for this type of a PDE. So therefore, you know, minus b plus or minus square root of discriminant, there is no plus or minus. There's just, it's, you add zero, plus zero or minus zero, it's the same. So there is only one root you get for this. There are not two roots like we had in the hyperbolic case. So once you get this single root, we can actually go ahead and, you know, connect it to this this curve zeta of x comma y equal to c1, right, in a manner very similar to how we did with the hyperbolic type. So we consider this curve zeta of x comma y equal to some constant c1, we call it. Suppose we take, you know, a differential of this, d zeta is going to be 0 because along this curve the values are constant, but we can write this d zeta is dou zeta by dou x times dx plus dou zeta by dou y times dy, which in turn allows us to work out the slope along this curve. dy by dx is given by minus of this ratio, but this ratio is something we already know, right? So this ratio is minus b by 2a, so we get a plus b by 2a for dy by dx. So one of the two new coordinates can be found by simply solving for this differential equation. dy by dx is equal to b by 2a, we solve for this, and then we can, you know, we'll get a curve which corresponds to this zeta of x comma y equal to c1, and then from which we can read off this coordinate, new coordinate zeta of x comma y, right? So for a parabolic PDE, using this technique, we are going to get one coordinate, right? So we still have to get a second coordinate, so but we will see in a moment how that is actually fairly straightforward to get the other coordinate. But before we do that, let us quickly show that in fact capital A equal to 0 automatically implies that B equal to 0. We don't need to put this capital B equal to 0 separately in this condition. So if you can choose capital A equal to 0 in a in equation of parabolic type, then automatically capital B is also going to be 0. So the way to argue is as follows. So we know that capital B, according to this box of relations that we have worked out, which is completely general, is given by this expression. So we have capital B is equal to 2a times dou zeta by dou x times dou eta by dou x plus b times dou zeta by dou x times dou eta by dou y plus dou zeta by dou y times dou zeta by dou x, the whole thing, plus 2 times c times dou zeta by dou y times dou zeta by dou y. Right, so this is the general expression for B. Now we can rewrite this as, I mean, the first term can remain as it is, but in place of B we can write 2 times square root of AC, right? So because this is a differential PDE of a parabolic type, so B squared is equal to 4 small AC, which is, so therefore B is equal to 2 times square root of AC, and then all this stuff inside the bracket remains as it is. Then we have plus 2C. So now it's convenient to pull out this factor of 2 and then, you know, rewrite this as a square root of A times dou zeta by dou x plus square root of C times dou zeta by dou y times square root of A times dou eta by dou x plus square root of C times dou eta by dou y. You can quickly check that indeed we have just factorized this expression, right? So the way to check this is to actually multiply these two, and then you'll see that you get back this whole stuff. Now, because of the fact that this is a parabolic PDE, we can rewrite this, and also the fact that dou zeta, we already know the ratio of these, dou zeta by dou x divided by dou zeta by dou y. We can rewrite this dou zeta by dou x in terms of dou zeta by dou y times minus b by 2a, right? So that comes from here. So dou zeta by dou x is actually nothing but minus b by 2a times dou zeta by dou y. So if I replace this dou zeta by dou x by dou zeta by dou y times this factor minus b by 2a, then I can actually simplify this. This part I really leave it as it is. And then I see that once again it's convenient to rewrite this b as 2 times square root of ac. Then we have many simplifications. So this square root of a divided and a below will, there's some cancellation. So a, and we'll be just left with minus square root of c times dou zeta by dou y plus square root of c times dou zeta by dou y. So this actually, these two terms will cancel and give you a 0. And so effectively you're multiplying by 0. Therefore, it all gives you just a 0. So what we have managed to show is if you choose capital A to be 0, then automatically it implies that capital B is also 0. So we don't have to separately choose capital B, B to be 0. It automatically comes from the parabolic nature of this PDE, right? So thus, from all this, from putting capital A equal to 0, we have managed to just get one differential equation, one condition, so, or one characteristic curve, zeta of x comma y equal to c1. So we can get zeta of x comma y. So how do we get the other coordinate? So it turns out that you can actually choose any other coordinate you want, as long as it's not parallel to the first coordinate. What does that mean? It means that we must choose another coordinate such that the Jacobian of these two is non-zero, right? So you are making a transformation, and you just have to ensure that the Jacobian is non-zero, so that whatever information is contained in terms of these two variables x comma y will be written in terms of a new two variables. You cannot compress information of content of two independent variables in terms of just one independent variable. You still need two independent variables, so zeta and eta must be independent. So we can choose another variable arbitrarily, and it will all go through, right? So, and we will be able to rewrite it in terms of one of these two canonical forms. So finally, we will be able to just write it as dou squared u by dou zeta squared is some function of all this stuff. It can be quite complicated, but you will be able to write it either in this form or in this other form. Dou squared u by dou eta squared is equal to this complicated function, potentially complicated function, or a simple function. So all of this again is best illustrated with the aid of an example. So let's look at an example. Suppose we start with this PDE x squared times dou squared u by dou x squared plus 2xy times dou squared u by dou x dou y plus y squared times dou squared u by dou y squared equal to 0. So this corresponds to a being equal to x squared, b being equal to 2xy, and c being equal to y squared, and then of course d, e, f, g, all of them are 0. We have taken a relatively simple PDE to start with. And so the discriminant we see is just b squared minus 4ac, which is 4x squared y squared minus 4x squared y squared, which is 0 for all values of x and y. So this is a PDE of parabolic type for all x comma y. And to find the transformation that will convert this into the canonical form, we start with the characteristic equation. There is only one characteristic equation, it is of parabolic type. So dy by dx should be equal to b by 2a. So in this case, b is 2xy, and then 2a is 2x squared, so which is equal to y by x, which is a straightforward differential equation to solve. Dy by dx is equal to y by x. We get a straight line, y is equal to c1 times x, or y by x is equal to c1. And so the one of the coordinates is actually zeta of x comma y is equal to y by x, right? So this is a family of curves which pass through x comma y, and so then we just read off from here that the transformation, one of the coordinates to be chosen is zeta of x comma y equal to y by x. So now we have the freedom to choose the other coordinate, in lots of different ways. So one simple way to choose this eta of x comma y is to just choose it to be y. So if we do this, then we can quickly check that the Jacobian is given by this determinant. So dou zeta by dou x is, so times dou eta by dou y, so it is my dou zeta by dou x will give you minus y by x squared times 1, so minus y by x squared, but and the other one is dou eta by dou x is 0, so this part will not even contribute, so we are just left with minus y by x squared, which is not 0 in general. Therefore, to obtain the canonical form, we have to make this transformation, right? So you can check that capital A will be 0. We have worked this out, we have said that on general principles this has to be so, but you can check that indeed this is true for this particular choice of zeta and eta. Explicitly you can check this is 0, and D is 0. And C, here it turns out to be y squared, which can be written as eta squared, and then D, E, F, G, all of them will be 0, as you can check, right? So this requires a little bit of algebra, but you can convince yourself that indeed this is true, this is 0, and this stuff is anyway 0, F, G are also 0. So the PDE becomes actually very simple, In this case, it's just eta squared times dou squared u by dou eta squared is 0, or equivalently, it's just dou squared u by dou eta squared equal to 0. It's as simple as this, which is indeed in one of the canonical forms for parabolic PDE. And then if you have to, you can actually write down the solution in this case in very general terms. So if you integrate it twice, if you integrate it once, you will get a, you know, function f of zeta, right? It can be an arbitrary function of zeta, is basically a constant. And then if you integrate it a second time, you'll get an eta times f of zeta plus another constant as far as eta is concerned, which can be a function of zeta. So this is the general solution. And if you switch back to the original variables, you can write down the solution as u of x comma y is equal to y times f of y by x plus g of y by x. Okay, so that's all for this lecture. Thank you.